What is embodied cognition? It's actually the idea that the body and the mind work together, and that our bodily feelings, our physical sensations influence our thoughts, our decisions, our behaviors, our emotions, and what is more important, often without our awareness. In other words, the temperature of the things we touch, the texture of the things we touch, the colors we see, everything that we feel through our senses affect us not in the most obvious way, but in ways that we could not have imagined. I know that most people don't realize how major effect they have on our life. And it is important because if you walk in the street or if you touch something or the way I'm sitting now on a soft or hard chair or the distance between me and the camera, all these influence the way people perceive me and I perceive others. And as a consequence, the way we behave. And once we know it, we can be less manipulated by these physical experiences and maybe come to more judgments that are based on the real issue rather than on things which are actually irrelevant in a way. So we all know that we use metaphors. We say somebody is a warm person, I had a heavy decision, I had a hard day, a rough day, we had a smooth sailing. If you notice, what do? We take a concrete concept and we use it to describe more abstract concept. We say somebody is a warm person, so we take a concrete concept such as a warm temperature and to describe a personality which is more an abstract concept. Or we say I had a rough day, we use the texture rough, that we all know what it is, to describe something more abstract. Metaphors are not just figures of speech. They are more than that. They are part of the process of understanding concepts in our cognitions. And I can start with temperature to show this effect, and then I'll go along all the other senses. Temperature, let's start with temperature. We touch warm and hot and cold things all the time. We hold our coffee or our iced coffee, beverages, we take a bath or shower, we go to the swimming pool. We touch all the time hot and cold things. How do they affect us? So, as I said before, we use the term a warm personality, warm-hearted, etc. Two researchers from Yale University, William and Barge, decided to examine what is the meaning of this metaphor, whether it has more than just figure of speech. So what they did was they invited participants to their laboratory, and when each participant came to the lab, he was accompanied by an experimenter to the fourth floor in the elevator. What the participants didn't know is that the experiment actually started in the elevator, because the experimenter had her hands full. And at a certain point, she asked each participant, could you hold my cup of coffee for a minute for me while I'm writing your name? Now, for half of the participants, she handed a cold cup of coffee, an iced coffee. For the other half, she handed a warm cup of coffee. That's all. And then she took her cup of coffee back. Then they came to the lab immediately after that, and they were asked to judge a person they never knew about certain characteristics. The amazing result was that those who held a cold cup of coffee in the elevator judged that person as less warmer, considering personality, than those who held a warm cup of coffee. In other words, those who held a warm cup of coffee judged that person as a nicer person, a friendlier, a warm-hearted person, compared to those who held a cold cup of coffee. Now, these researchers wanted to find out whether it's not only affecting judgment of others, but actual behavior. So in a second experiment, they told participants that they are participating in a marketing study where they had to hold for a few minutes a therapeutic pad. Half of the subject held a warm therapeutic pad, the other half a cold therapeutic pad, and then they were asked some questions about the product, as if it was a marketing study. And then they were offered as a reward for their participation either to choose either a gift for themselves or a gift for a friend. Those who held a warm therapeutic pad chose more often a gift for a friend than a gift for themselves, and more often chose a gift for a friend than those who held a cold therapeutic fit. In other words, it affected their generosity. If I take all these together, that just the touch of something warm or cold affected the way we perceive others, the way we behave, and the way we trust others. Think about how these implications have so many implications in real life situation. When you interact, whether it's a business negotiation, or whether you interact with your friends, with your family, with your children, with your spouse, with your boss, whatever, you definitely want that the other person will perceive you as a nicer person. You definitely want that person to be more generous and trust you more.